前面回家。在这时刻，我邀请所有人都一起站立起来。我们一起来敬拜赞美我们的神。今天早上我们要来宣告。我们世世代代都要敬拜我们的神。我们也宣告，我们要夺回这个时代。哈利路亚！我们一起来敬拜神。
十字架。你牺牲的救赎，复活主，我重新的盼望，恳求主使用我夺回这时代。
十字架，
十字架，你牺牲的救赎，复活主，我重新的盼望，恳求主使用我夺回这时代。
One, two, three, go。
神创造天地，从无到有，看一切为美好。地点，你我的乐园，如此的美妙。欢颜都结了生命，从有到无，将一切都毁坏。罪恶追赶着我，直到你的到来。你牺牲的救赎，复活主，我从今的盼望，恳求主使用我夺回这时代。我宣告黑暗的变卦，你要你的要盛开，暗淡的成为璀璨，我用信心看见你国降临。软弱的的刚强，捆绑的的自由，微笑的总比发达，你同在带领我夺回这时代。
哈利路亚，夺回这时代。
起初先创造天地，从无到有，看一切为美好。一点离我的乐园如此的美妙，谎言偷窃了生命，从有到无，将一切都毁坏。罪恶追赶着我，直到你的到来。
十字架，
十字架，牺牲的救赎，复活主，我重新的盼望，恳求主使用我夺回这时代。
我们先来宣告十字架，
十字架，你牺牲的救赎，复活主，我重新的盼望，恳求主使用我夺回这时代。我宣告黑暗的变卦，你凋零的药水，但暗淡的成为璀璨，我用信心看见你国家里。软弱的的刚强，捆绑的的自由，微笑的总比发达，同在带领我夺回这时代。
一起来宣告，
我宣告你凋零的要盛开，暗淡的成为璀璨，我用信心看见你国降临。软弱的的刚强，捆绑的的自由，微笑的双臂发达，你同在带领我，你同在带领我，这时代。
哈利路亚，是的，
God is on our side. He has all the power.
们感谢你，你的话都应值得跟我们说，神，你的祝福常与我们同在。主啊，今天我们要更大的来领受你给我们的一切。主啊，我们来敬拜你。
Generations and your family. for you.
起来敬拜。
Welcome back to the house of God, all brothers and sisters.
那我想问，在我们当中有没有第一次来的？
May I ask if there's anyone who's here among us for the first time today?
有吗？
Anyone?
有吗？你是第一次来？哦，有，在我们的当中，在我的左边有一个姐妹。
So on my left, a sister here.
中间也有一位。
And also in the middle.
那我要对你说呢 ，GA 一次欢迎，永远欢迎。
GA once welcome, forever welcome.
那我们也跟我们周围至少三个人也跟他说
，That also greet at least three persons around us.
非常的 enjoy 跟你一起敬拜。
Tell them I really enjoy worshiping together with you.
回到神的家敬拜真好。
It's so good to be able to come back to worship God in the house of God.
感谢神。
Praise the Lord.
弟兄姐妹，我们可以请坐。
Brothers and sisters, please be seated.
那我们预备好我们的心来奉献。
Let us prepare our hearts for offering.
那圣经里面有一句记载着
，The Bible states that
我们的财宝在哪里，我们的心就在哪里。
Where our treasure is, there our heart will also be.
那我们就预备好我们的奉献。
So let us prepare our offering.
我们预备好我们要献的十分一也好，或者是。建殿的或者是其他的甘心乐意的奉献带到神的面前
Whether it is our tithe for church building or other free will offering Let us bring it before God
然后我们对神说
Let us say to God
神我的心就在你的家
God my heart is in your house
所以我甘心乐意的把这些奉献献到神你的面前
I'm willing to sacrifice all of this and bring it before you
那弟兄姐妹可以透过在荧幕上的账号我们可以转账
So brothers and sisters can do an online transfer according to the accounts listed here.
或者你有带奉献来到现场的，等下上会过后呢，可以把它放进奉献栏。
Or if you've brought cash, you may also drop it off into the gift basket here after the service.
那我们一起来祷告。
Let us pray together.
天父爸爸，我们谢谢你。
Heavenly Father, we give you thanks.
因为得获财的能力是你给我们的。
Because the ability to earn comes from you.
当你感动我们要这样奉献的时候。
As you prompt us to offer as such,
神，你早就为我们预备了。
You have already prepared for us.
所以我们带到神你的家中。
So we bring it before your house.
献给神你的时候，神啊，你完全的悦纳。
And as we sacrifice it to you, you are well pleased.
而且神，你祝福你的孩子，你的百姓。
And you bless your people, your children.
多而又多。
Overflowing.
谢谢你听我们的祷告。
Thank you for listening to our prayer.
奉耶稣基督的名。
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. 感谢神，神的祝福是多而又多。
Praise the Lord for His blessings is always overflowing.
弟兄姐妹平安。
Peace to you, brothers and sisters.
现在来到我们的家事报告。
Right now, it's time for our in-house announcements.
今天我们有四项的报告。
Today, we have four items.
第一项就是 YouTube 网上装备课程。
The first one is YouTube equipping course online.
就是长大成熟。
That's growing towards maturity.
不过这次是英文版本。
This time, we'll be releasing the English version.
所以欢迎弟兄姐妹报名。
Welcome, brothers and sisters, to register.
开课日期是5月18号。
Commencement day is on the 18th of May.
报名截止日期是5月15号。
Registration deadline on the 15th of May.
第二项呢，就是沙伦玫瑰的母亲节活动。
And second is our Rose of Sharon Mother's Day event.
日期在5月15号星期三。
It's on the 15th of May on a Wednesday.
早上10点半。
10:30 a.m.
就是婆媳秘籍，老公乐悠悠。
This is the tips for the in-laws make the husband happy.
这个对于我们的就是媳妇跟婆婆之间的，我觉得是非常棒的一个课程。
I think this is an excellent course for relationships between mothers-in-law and daughters-in-law.
欢迎我们当中的姐妹报名。
So welcome sisters to join us.
然后呢，也欢迎所有弟兄姐妹，哦、不，姐妹。
And we also welcome all sisters.
带着你的新朋友一起来参加
To bring your new friends to join us
感谢神第三项呢就是 Seekers Gathering
And thirdly, Seekers Gathering
这个也是母亲节的外展哦
This is a Mother's Day Outreach
主题是你是超级妈妈
The title is You're a Supermom
我想我们每一个做妈妈都想成为超级妈妈
I believe that every mother here would like to be a supermom
日期是5月11号的下午2点地点是在 Marquee
The date is 11th of May, 2 p.m. at Marquee
最后一项呢
And finally,
就是我们期待已久的吴婷牧师会在我们当中。
It is our long anticipated Reverend David Wu will be in our midst.
所以在5月18号星期六的第一堂崇拜，他会分享信息。
So on the 18th of May, in the first service, he'll be sharing the message.
所以请大家预留时间。
So let's reserve your time.
接下来呢，是我们今天有一个很特别的见证。
And after this, we have a special testimony.
见证过后呢
，And after the testimony,
我们今天的主任牧师的话也是很特别。
Our words from City Pastor today is also very special.
所以我们要热烈的掌声欢迎来自乌干达的 Pastor Joda 跟师母 Rhoda。
So, 掌声欢迎他们 ，Pastor Joda and Rev. Rhoda Simo。
Good morning to all pastors, believers, and sisters of GA611.
各位牧者同工弟兄姐妹，大家早上好。
My name is Pastor Judah Mhunza from Uganda, and this is my beautiful wife, Rhoda Simo.
我是从乌干达来的 Pastor Judah, 这个是我漂亮的妻子 Rhoda Simo.
We want to thank God for leading us this wonderful family.
首先，我要感谢神带领我们来到这个美好的家庭。
In my former ministry, I used to travel do missions in different nations.
在过去我的服事里头呢，我去到很多国家来做宣教的工作。
Like Taiwan, Korea, South Korea, and Holy Land.
好像台湾、南韩、香港、圣地等等。
I have worked hard.
我很努力的服事。
To serve with all my strength.
用尽我一切。
But I go back home with no results.
但是我却没有带来任何的果效。
So stressful.
加上有很多的压力。
I remember the times I used to raise money for my air ticket.
我记得很多时候我必须要筹款来买我的回程机票。
And leaving my family alone for too long, it was so difficult.
然后加上要离开家庭这样久的时间是很挑战的。
My wife made this prayer this time as I was planning to go to the Holy Land.
这一次当我要去到圣地服事的时候我太太做了一个祷告
This was her prayer. She said, Lord, this time connect my husband to right people.
她求神帮助我可以连接上对的人
And while I was serving in the Department of Transport at All Nations Convocation Jerusalem
在耶路撒冷列国聚会的时候我是在交通部里面服事
I was told I'm going to be the one to fetch Reverend Joshua and Rabbi from Jerusalem.Ben-Gurion Airport.
而我负责载送张牧师和路比牧师从耶路撒冷去到机场。
On our way to the airport,
在路上
they started asking me where am I from.
他们开始问我从哪里来。
And they begin to share about 611.
然后开始分享有关于611。
I got excited.
而我就觉得很兴奋。
I wanted to know more.
我想了解更多
about 611.
我想了解更多关于611。
Then they said to me.
然后他们告诉我
For us, we value relationship and family.
我们看重关系和家庭
It touched my heart.
这句话触动了我
So much because it has been always a long prayer.
因为这个是我们的渴慕和祷告
And I longed for it.
我们的渴慕
So I would love to know more about 611.
为了要了解更多611呢
We exchanged our contacts and that was September 2023.
我们交换彼此的联络方式这一切是在去年的9月。
I went back home to Uganda.
然后我回到乌干达。
Shared with my wife.
跟我的妻子分享。
After a few months, 611 Hong Kong connected us Reverend Esther and Reverend Amos.
香港611就连接上帮助我们连接上 Esther 和 Amos 牧师
through WhatsApp and we were invited to Malaysia
然后他们就邀请我来到马来西亚
arriving in Malaysia on the 15th of March highly welcome to the airport
3月15号我们来到马来西亚在机场我们就感受到很被欢迎
and then we reached the home of GA
然后来到了 GA611 这个大家庭
it was beautiful
是的何等的美好
welcomed by Reverend Esther and Reverend Amos
因为 Esther 牧师、Emma 牧师这样子来欢迎我们
and the entire co-workers team
然后还有整个同工团队
we have experienced a lot
我们在这里经历很多
especially the close relationship between the senior pastor and the co-workers
特别是跟主任牧师还有同工之间的关系
they shared the heart
他们敞开他们的心
took us for meals
带我们去用餐
they take care of us
照顾我们的需要
I feel loved and accepted
我感觉被爱和被接纳
Than ever before I've experienced.
这些是我以前都没有经历过的
The core values,
还有核心价值
especially more love, more trust.
特别是有爱有信任
we have experienced how Reverend Esther and Amos live it.
我们见证 Amos 牧师、Esther 牧师如何的活出来，
and it has impacted our lives.
并且如何影响我们的生命。
We are so grateful and touched.
我们很感恩，也很感动。
We feel we are no longer orphans.
我们不再觉得自己是孤儿。
But now have spiritual parents and family.
现在我们有属灵父母还有家人。
That you can look to and cover us when we are in need.
在我们需要的时候，他们可以来帮助遮盖我们。
We feel this belonging.
我们感觉到这里是我们的归属。
The morning devotion.
还有晨祷啊。
Wow. We're always longing for that toward the beautiful time of the morning.
每一个早上我们都很向往这个时光。
Beside all these things,
除了这些,
we are so touched by many teachings.
还有很多的教导。
The way of the pastoring of the MG12.
比如说透过 MG12 的牧养方式。
The feast of the Lord.
耶和华神的节期。
And many new to us, but we're excited.
还有很多新的教导，对我们来说，我们都很兴奋。
We believe God is leading us.
我们相信神带领我们。
To a new path to build a Tree of Life Church in Uganda.
带领我们去到乌干达建立生命树的教会。
3 weeks ago, when Reverend Esther and Amos had a trip to Saudi Arabia,
三个星期前 Amos 牧师和 Esther 牧师去沙地阿拉伯之前
she left us with an assignment.
他们给我一个的功课
of believing God for a new identity in this new path.
就是在这个新的道路上找到我们的身份。
And told us we're going to be commissioned on the 5th of May, which is today.
并且告诉我们五月五号就是今天会有一个的差派。
Then the morning of 24th, early in the morning at 3, the Holy Spirit woke me up to pray.
然后四月二十四号凌晨三点，圣灵叫醒我起来来祷告。
Later, 师母 joined me.
师母也跟我一起来祷告。
Prayed for 1 hour and went back to sleep.
我们祷告一个小时，然后睡了。
I saw a young boy in my dream.
然后我做了一个梦，看见一个年轻的男孩。
Ask me, do you know that Reverend Esther is coming back?
问我，你知道 Esther 牧师要回来了吗？
The question she has for you,
她给你的问题
is about fruits.
是有关于果子。
I came out of the dream.
我醒过来。
Shared with my wife.
跟我太太分享。
And we felt that was the leading given. It's an answer to Reverend Esther's question.
我们觉得神给了我们那个答案。
2 days later,
两天过后
on the 26th, we were going to read Numbers 26.
四月二十六号，我们晨祷读到民数记。民数记二十六章。
This was about the census of Israelites.
是关乎于数点。
And Reverend Esther was going to do the major conclusion.
也是 Esther 牧师做总结。
As she was sharing,
在她分享的时候
I saw the tribe of Reuben.
我看见吕便支派。
Which had no blessing.
他是不蒙福的。
But I didn't know how to do about it.
我不知道如何的反应。
Because I have lived this name for the last 49 years.
因为过去49年我都是以吕便的身份活着。
After the morning devotion, we went for breakfast.
晨祷过后我们去早餐。
Deep inside of me about Reuben.
在我里面一直在想着吕便这个事情。
As we were booking a table, we found it was 55.
然后我们在餐桌的时候，我们看到餐桌号码是55号。
And you know how meaning to be significant meaning to me about the number, and I knew to me it was grace after grace.
这五十五的意思对我来说就是恩上加恩。
While on the table, Reverend Esther pulls me and look at me and say, "That Reuben is not a good name."
然后在餐桌上 ，Esther 牧师看着我就对我说
，So we need to change it.
吕便不是好名，要改名。
Tell Reverend Amos to give you a new name.
然后叫 Amos 牧师给你一个新名。
Right away, I was given a new name, Judah.
当下我就给了新名 Judah, 犹大。
Wow. Immediately,
立刻
after a new name, something left my life.
我感觉到有东西离开了我的生命。
I felt a new season has come.
我觉得进入到一个新的季节了。
And I perceived it.
然后我领受。
I received a new song in my heart.
然后我心里也领受了一首新歌。
The Lion of Judah has broken every chain and given us power. Hallelujah, day by day.
犹大的狮子断开一切锁链。每一日都给我们加上能力。
We shared the dream to Reverend Ames and Reverend Esther, and they told us we are entering a new season, and shared with us a scripture in Numbers 25.
然后我们也跟 Esther 牧师、Amos 牧师分享我们的梦，他们也告诉我们进入新的季节。
We confirmed the name of a new church.
然后透过马太福音和与创世纪给了我们教会新名字。
BGFF611 Bread of Life Church.Uganda,
就是乌干达 GFF 610粮堂。
Our vision is great, faithful, and leads to great fruitfulness.
我们的意向就是极大的信心啊，极大的忠心带来极大的果子。
All happen on the same day.
这一切发生在同一天。
And after that, blessing after blessing.
然后祝福, 借着祝福
also electronics closes, they bless all of us.
包括电子产品还有所有的衣服
including the tablet, the laptop for our new church, wow.
其中有我们教会的新的平板还有电脑
Now we are going back to Uganda.
现在我们就要回乌干达了
With this 盼望
我们带着盼望回去
About our future destiny.
因为我们对我们的未来有盼望
We give thanks to Reverend Esther.Reverend Amos,
我们谢谢 Esther 牧师还有 Emma 牧师
the entire GA611 family,
还有整个 GA61 的家庭
of your generosity,
谢谢你们的
your love,
慷慨你们的爱
your care,
你们的照顾
your financial support,
你们经济上的
资源 that you have rendered to us for the last past few weeks, seven weeks here in Malaysia,
还有过去七个星期里面所栽种在我们生命里头的
we go back to Uganda,
我们回去乌干达的时候
remembering this word,
我们亦会记得这句话
Once welcome, forever welcome.
一次欢迎，永远欢迎。
We give glory and honor to our God.
将一切荣耀、颂赞都归于我们的神。
Amen.
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 感谢神。
Give thanks to God.
是很快时间又过去了。
And time really flies.
然后我们看到神的带领。
And we see God's guidance.
就是他们从乌干达来
and they came from Uganda.
我们在乌干达已经在坎巴拉已经有了一个教会
We already have a church in Kampala.
但是张牧师跟他们认识只一面之缘
So Reverend Joshua just got to know them.
然后张牧师就打电话来
And he called us.
他说 Esther, 你既然有一间乌干达教会在坎巴拉，那可以有第二间啊。
And he said that since you already have a church in Kampala, Uganda, you can have another one.
我说可以啊，牧师。
And I say sure.
你叫我做什么，我都帮你的。
Whatever you say, then I will just follow.
他说你去牧养那时候的 Reuben 和 Rhoda.
And he said that you go and shepherd Pastor Reuben then and also Rhoda Simo.
来，我还记得我们是一月份到泰国我们的度假的时候，跟他们在网上见面。
It was January when we were actually on a vacation in Thailand when we actually met with them online.
然后我们也是第一次见面。
It was also our first time meeting them.
但是我也看到他们的渴慕。
And I see their desire.
我说就安排时间过来吧。
So to arrange time for them to come over.
因为我们相信关系先走。
We believe that we need to build relationship first.
先关系后事工。
Relationship before ministry.
所以他们就真的放下。在乌干达他们有的一个幼稚园然后放下然后就过来
So they truly laid down the kindergarten over there and also came over
还有一间很小的教会
And also a small church
他们就来了
So they came here
所以这两个月跟着我们一起走
So in these 2 months they have been following us
我们也看到他们的渴慕
And we see their hunger
我也相信他们回去真的可以为神做更奇妙的事。
And I believe as they go back, they will do greater things for the Lord.
所以在乌干达，在同个城市有两个教会，哦，他们将会有很多的互动了。
In Uganda, we shall have two daughter churches, and they will have a lot of interaction.
他们就会 double blessing 了。
And they have double blessings.
所以我们感谢神。
Give thanks.
所以今天五月五号。
So today is the 5th of May.
所以 5-5.
5-5.
然后faithful and fruitful.
And is faithful and fruitful.
这是他们一直的祷告，就是 Where is our fruit? Where is our fruit?
And that has been their prayer to ask about where is their fruit.
所以他们的成果在哪里？他们常常问，我们没有成果。
So often they are asking because they are not having any fruit.
我说，因为你们过去的服事是忠心的。
And I say because you have been faithful in the past.
他们在一个机构被差派很多地方，自己掏腰包都去的。
They're in an organization being sent here and there that even need to pay for their own fare.
就是因为他们忠心。
But it's because of their faithfulness.
没有问成果。
And they're not asking about the result.
我说接下来 fruitful 就跟着你了。
And then fruitfulness shall follow you.
因为我们所栽种的一定会有成果的。
Because what we sow we shall reap.
Amen.
Amen.
好，我们现在就来差派了。
And we shall do the commissioning ceremony now. Okay.
耶稣，今天我们把 Pastor Judah 还有 Rhoda 交在你的手中。
Lord Jesus, we commit Pastor Judah and Rhoda to your hands. In Jesus' my name,
代表耶稣基督
representing Jesus Christ,
天父爸爸圣灵
the Heavenly Father and the Holy Spirit,
还有 GA611粮堂全体的弟兄姐妹
and GA611 all the brothers and sisters.
我们要正式差派
want to officially commission
Judah
Pastor Judah，
还有师母 Roda，
Roda 师母，
我们奉耶稣的名字
，In Jesus my name，
差派他们回乌干达
，We commission them to go back to Uganda，
回到 Kampala，
and back to the city of Kampala，
回到他们的家乡
，to their hometown，
建立
，to build up。
GA 六一灵粮堂的分堂
，The Daughter Church of Jesus One One Bread of Life，
奉耶稣基督的名字
，In Jesus My Name，
他们的分堂
，Their Church，
因为他们的忠心
，And because of their faithfulness，
主他们将会有很多的果子
，They shall see many fruits，
fruitful，
being fruitful，
所以 GA 六一一。
So Jesus One One
所差派的分堂
，The Daughter Church
是带着我们的祝福出去的。
Is bringing about our blessing to go out.
奉耶稣基督的名字
，In Jesus My Name.
GFF 六一一
，GFF 611
正式被差派。
Is being commissioned officially.
回到 Kampala.
Back to Kampala.
我宣告
，And I declare.
神你的能力与他们同在。
God's power be upon them.
保护他们。
To protect them, Lord.
保护他们的教会。
To protect their church.
保守他们手中所做的工。
And keep the works of their hands.
耶稣，
Lord Jesus.
愿一切荣耀都归给。
May all the glory be upon you.
耶稣，我们要宣告。
Lord Jesus, we declare.
神的恩宠在他们的身上。
Your favor upon them.
神的保护在他们身上。
Your protection upon them.
神的脸光光照他们。
And you make your face shine upon them.
神扬起他的救恩的脸向他们显现。
And lift out the countenance of salvation upon them.
主啊，你给他们有恩典。
And give them grace.
是恩上加恩。
Grace upon grace.
恩宠加恩宠。
Favor upon favor.
人数倍增又倍增
and to multiply upon multiplying
主啊我们在这里有的一切
and everything that we have here
他们也有
they shall have it as well
主啊我们有人数
we have the number of people
主啊他们也有
they shall also have it
主啊我们有非常好的经济
and we have good financial situation
他们比我们更加有
and they shall build upon it
我们要宣告灵粮堂的恩典临到他们
the grace of bread of life shall come upon them
就是先召召聚的恩膏
and that's the anointing of gathering
是的 凡是有灵粮堂到的地方
And wherever bread of life go to
有召聚的能力
That has the anointing of gathering
吸引万人归向你
To attract many people to you Lord
主啊有六一一的恩膏
And also have the anointing of 611
圣灵恩膏膏抹他们
The Holy Spirit anoint them
把好信息传福音给需要的人
Preach the good news to those in need
我们有大军的恩膏临到他们
And our anointing of great army shall come upon them
使枯骨站起来
Cause the dry bones to arise
变成大军
to become a great army
可以征战得胜
to war and have the victory
所有一切恶者的作为完全要退开
all the works of the enemy shall retreat from us
谢谢你主耶稣
thank you Lord Jesus
与我们同在
be with us
就是我们奉耶稣名字要祝福 Pastor Judah 和 Roda 师母
in Jesus my name I want to bless Pastor Judah and also Roda 师母
就是我们要宣告主啊我们站在绝律粮堂福音部的权柄能力降在他们身上
and may the power and also anointing of the evangelical department of GA come upon them
就是说让他们成为你里面的大族
that they will become a great tribe and nation
就像犹大一样
just like the tribe of Judah
就是说让他们起来为你传扬福音的时候
to rise up and also evangelize for you
宣告他们口所说的
and the words that they say
许多神迹奇事就随着他们
many signs and wonders
主要他们需要有更多的能力
They need more power.
甚至死人复活的神迹要发生
And even the miracles of the dead resurrected
will happen. 让他们在 Uganda, Kampala 这个地方
In Uganda, in Kampala.
为你来大收割
To greatly harvest for you.
让他们在你里面
And in you, Lord.
兴起许多许多神国的大军
And rise up the great army of Christ.
奉耶稣之名祝福他们
In Jesus' my name, we bless them.
Pastor Judah 师母，当我为你们祷告的时候
，Pastor Judah and also Roda 师母 ，as I pray for you，
我看见神把一个全新的新郎和新娘的衣服穿在你们身上。
And I see that God is putting on the garment of the bride and also bridegroom upon you。
神说过去的已经过去。
And God said that what is past is past。
今年是你们安息的一年。
And this year is the year of Sabbath。
明年是喜年。
And next year is the jubilee year.
是给你们的喜年。
It's your jubilee year.
我看见很多的夫妻来到你们的面前。
And I've seen many couples come to you.
我看到他们得医治，他们得释放。
And they're being healed and also released.
我看到你们跟很多的孩子在跳舞。
And you're dancing together with children.
跳完过后，你们教导神的话。
And after dancing, you're teaching the word of God.
神讲说，我把一个家庭的事工放在你们里面。
And God said, I give you the ministry of families.
你们建立很多生命树的家庭。
You build many tree of life families.
你们成为很多人的祝福。 祝福。
And become a blessing to many people.
在接下来的日子，我有看到征战临到你们。
In the days to come, I will see warfare coming.
但是神讲说不要害怕。
But God is saying, do not be afraid.
持守忠心。
To keep to it and also be faithful.
就必看见生命树的果子。
And you shall see the fruits of the tree of life.
愿神祝福你们。
May God greatly bless you.
当我祷告的时候，感觉到新的季节要来到。
As I was praying, I see feel a new season coming upon you.
好像就是在洪水过后，就是格子叼着一片新的嫩叶的季节来到。
And just like after the great flood, there was actually a dove that is taking this leaf.
众多遍满全地
God wants to bless you to be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth
是重新生养敬虔的后裔的时代
And it's time to actually give birth to devoted generation
而且夫妻要跟下一代下一代世世代代的一起来站在位置上来迎接这个的属灵征战
And husband and wife shall join hands together and together with the next generation to face the spiritual warfare.
在牧羊上，奉耶稣的圣名祝福你们，要多而又多。
In shepherding, I bless you to multiply upon multiplying.
成为众生之父母。
And to become the father and mother of nations.
在乌干达甚至其他的地方都能够遍植生命树。
In Uganda and also many nations to actually multiply the tree of life.
奉耶稣的圣名祷告。
In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.Lord Jesus, we come before you.
主，我们在教师的职分祝福我们的分堂。
And standing upon the position of the teacher to bless our daughter churches.
主啊，在诗篇三十三篇第五节还有第九节这么说。
In Psalm 33 verse 6 and also verse 9 it says.
诸天借耶和华的命而造。
By the word of the Lord, the heavens were made.
万象借他口中的气而成。
And all the hosts of them by the breath of his mouth.
因为他说有就有。
For he spoke and it was done.
命立就立。
He commanded and he stood fast.
他说有就有。
He spoke and it was done.
说命立就立。
He commanded and he stood fast.
主啊，创造宇宙万物的话语的能力在他们的口中。
The creator of the universe, the power of the word is upon them.
建造教会的能力在他们手中。
The ability to build church is upon them.
主，他们说有就有。
And as they speak, it shall be done.
命立就立。
As the command, it will stand still.
主，他们教会要成为你神话语的出口。
And they will become the outlet of God's words.
建立教会。
To build a church.
建立门徒。
To build disciples.
建立这个国家。
To build this nation.
谢谢耶稣。
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
奉耶稣
In Jesus' my name.
Amen.
Amen.
耶稣来到你的面前。
Lord Jesus, we come before you.
我宣告。
I declare.
主啊，他Judas 手中所做的工。
And the works of the hands of Pastor Judah.
还有师母所做的工。
And Rhoda 师母。
主啊，都有果效。
Will be effective.
都有果子。
Will bear fruit.
我奉耶稣基督的名字。
In Jesus' my name.
复兴要临到他们当中。
Revival shall come upon them.
下一代要被兴起来。
Next generation shall rise up.
耶稣，你的恩典与他们同在。
Your grace be upon them.
保守他们。
Protect them, Lord.
相信。
To believe,
神的能力
God's power,
透过 GFF 611粮堂
and through GFF 611
要祝福 Uganda
to bless Uganda
过去他们也很多人出去做宣教
in the past a lot of people go out to do mission
今天他们自己的国家要被兴起来
and today their own nation shall be rise
up 愿主耶稣与他们同在
may the Lord Jesus be upon them
给他们有信心
and give them faith
给他们有盼望
give them hope
给他们有恩典
and give them grace
超乎他们所想所求
Imagine, Lord.
谢谢你
Thank you, Lord.
祷告奉耶稣的名
In Jesus' my name we pray
Amen Hallelujah
Hallelujah
Amen
Amen
Okay, let's stand
欢迎他们
Welcome them
感谢神
Give thanks to God
盼望我们年尾可以去开堂
And we hope we can go for the inauguration
不然就是明年头
Or the beginning of next year
是
明年头可以了、
啊、明年头
We can do so next year
所以我们盼望他们很快把教会建立起来
And we hope they can build out the church very quickly
有很多人可以跟随他们
And many people can follow them
感谢神我们今天的差派礼就到这里
That's the end of the commissioning ceremony
好我们就来看主任牧师的话
And let's watch the words of the senior pastor
7241 wind, calm runway 23 clear to land.
要有十二股水泉在我们每一个教会里面、
yes.
每一个教会都有充足的供应、
嗯、
就是在我们饥难的时候
是
在干渴的地带的时候你就是主耶稣你就是我们的以灵水泉、
是真的很不容易的，所以我也知道在弟兄姐妹的生活里面也是很不容易的，很多时候是很挑战、很艰难，很炎日、都是石头，好像没有盼望，没有、云，今天都没有云，所以好像是没有帮助，但是神却可以在这样的环境他可以行神迹，然后活水在这样的地方涌流出来，所以可以喂饱这200多万的百姓，所以我绝对相信神的手没有缩短、神的眼光没有、很短视，神是很扩大的，所以我们来到神的面前相信他，继续的向他求问，天神祝福你们，
也祝福大家。
Hello， 欢迎大家回到我们这一期主任牧师的话。我们很开心呢，我们在上个星期我们说到我们去到沙地阿拉伯这个地方、嗯、去到神的山，就是西乃山。
是，
我觉得这个经历是非常特别的。
是，
我们也是从红海开始，
是，
也是那个以色列登陆的地方，就是从对面呢是埃及过到这里，我们从那边开始筑坛。我们有发现啊，东风啊原来是从沙地阿拉伯这一个吹向埃及那一个方向，东从东吹到西嘛，因为以色列人那时候是在埃及这个摩阿巴比这里等着神开那个红海、嗯、当摩西举杖的时候他打下去的时候，他我们都是想红海会分开，但是原来呢东风已经在前个晚上从那里吹，水已经开始做、分开了。我们很多时候就面对问题、嗯、我们都不知道原来神已经老早为我们预备了，已经老早在动工了，我们都不晓得、嗯、因为东风已经是从对面吹过来、
嗯、
红海已经开始干了，
对，
我们只要凭信心踏入去然后打开它就打开，原来是神就在那边等我们，过来过来，我这里我已经为你预备好了，这样子是很感恩的，是很感动的这一个事情。
是咯，
以色列人是神迹般过了红海，然后就去到沙特阿拉伯那一边的旷野嘛、嗯、因为进入应许之地之前他们还要经过旷野的、嗯、所以我们这次去到旷野的时候就是看见原来真的很不容易、嗯、旷野是只有石头、嗯、还有个很远很远很远就有一棵那一个香不是香
阿卡夏
阿卡夏树、嗯、然后地上满都是那个荆棘、嗯、所以其实、原来去到应许之地之前其实是有一段很艰难的路，
是
看起来是一片荒凉，好像是不可能可以在那里生存的、嗯、但是当我们去到那里看到哦，哇，远远就有一个井，一个井，一个井是当地政府为他们挖的、
嗯、那个是以林
啊，在以林那边、嗯、所以其实地下是有水的、嗯、其实神是有供应的，但是看在表面上是好像是很艰难不可能，其实神供应。那其实我在那边的时候我在想，我可以相信神所讲的，我一定会带你进入应许之地，
是、
嗯、其实我们真的是要相信神已经预备了，神说我们会去到就一定会去到，
是
其实就是看我们能不能
够
有多相信神可以带领我们每一个人进入他为我们预备的应许之地。
表面看来没有东西，你只看到一颗远远一颗远远一颗的这些阿卡西亚，然后呢我们要相信吗？要知道神有预备吗？在哪里呢？原来神是有预备的，
是
在下面，在看不到的地方。
对、嗯、对，所以当人看不见不相信就开始埋怨，
是
是，
就开始 complain 说、嗯、我要回去埃及了，我回去埃及更好了，就回去以前的路，旧路、嗯、感觉更舒适。但是如果回头的话，其实我们永远都去不到神给我们的应许。
是是，
那我觉得这一次整个旅程我最大的感动点就是爬西乃山哦。当然登西乃山是我们的目标跟方向、嗯、
要攻顶、
要攻顶，这是我们去、嗯、
爬大家都可以爬，
对对，爬大家都可以爬、那我们的目标就是要攻顶、但我觉得很感恩就是、牧师跟 Amos 牧师跟 S 牧师真的给我们机会去经历这个、我觉得人生当中可能是不会有机会经历的一个点。那我觉得当我们去的时候，我看那座山真的很高、嗯是我们无法想象的一个的很难的一个的
旅程
啊、但是在整个旅程当中哦，当我们爬上去的时候，我们是有设一个时间点的，嗯，因为我们知道去跟回是需要同样的时间的，
你要如果上四个小时，
对，
你
回也要四个小时，
然后我就跟导游一算一下咯，然后讲如果是一点回。应该还回到来应该是四五点或者五六点最多。
对。
然后我说如果再迟一点呢，就是一点十五分或者一点半，他说一点十五分了。嗯。我讲 OK 好，我就拿你的一点十五分。
对。所以我们就大概设定一个一点十五分，无论我们走到哪里我们都要回头。所以这个就是我们沟通好的。所以来到二重天，就是 Pastor Amos 去到的地方，他就告诉我们说 OK， 我们现在就留在那里，然后你们可以上的就继续上去攻顶、嗯、所以他就告诉我们说要做两件事情，第一个就是12点我们要停下来一起领圣餐，一起来祷告，一起来宣告、嗯、第二件事情就是1点15分无论你去到哪个点你就要下来、嗯、然后我们一起来在下面的聚合点来聚合、嗯、
是，
所以我就 OK 我们就去吧。所以我们很紧张，就一直爬一直爬，因为我们一直看时间，哇，还有两个小时多，我们一定要上到顶、嗯、我们一直走，然后到了大概11点55分的时候，诶，阿拉姆就想说 OK 我们要停下来找个地方我们就住谈，然后我们就一起领圣餐祷告、嗯、然后呢祷告完过后12点15分我们就还有一个小时，我们说 OK 我们就要冲上去那导游跟我们说应该是不是很可能的啦，但是我们就尽量啦，他就一直跑很快乐没有停了，一直在上，然后去到我们眼前看差不多看到那个顶了然后我们就说哎呀时间到了，然后我们就很挣扎，我问他们 OK 现在是要怎样，
因为还有25分钟我们就可以上到比较顶的地方了，顶的地方
他说大概25-30分钟我们就可以去到顶了，哇，那个挣扎点是很挣扎的，为什么呢？因为我们可能不会来第二次， 那个目标成就就在前面了，多二十分钟哎，我们已经排了五个小时上到去那里了。
那边是大家的荣誉，
大家的荣誉，你是很荣誉。但是还有二十分钟，要不要去？要去还是不要去？但是当我们在想的时候，我的心里一直告诉我说，你来到这个山，你要学习顺服吗？
神的山，
我就想到
神的山，
神的山，我就想到摩西，然后我就想到他是怎样的顺服点啊，然后百姓就是因为在下面，然后不听神啊，他们自己造反啊，造金牛犊各方面的得罪神，所以我很怕我上到去的时候同样的被烧死，因为那个是全部黑黑的然后就是神下来的神火下来的地方，所以我说还是告诉他们说 OK 我们停了，我们是要顺服，我们就下山。
那边也是到了黑的那边啊
的边界了，已经是边界了，已经是有黑石头的那个边界了，所以我们就说 OK 我们决定下山。那我觉得我很感恩，是因为我们的顺服其实也保护到我们整个团队，因为我觉得那里是非常危险，我想如果我再带队继续再跑个二十五三十分钟，
你没有力，
其实下来之后可能对于有一些团友是有挑战，
没有力的
啊，他们可能会因为太累很容易发生意外。
你们那七个人哦，
对对对，所以我觉得这个是我在那里很大经历，顺服吗还是我要得着我个人的那个荣誉啊，还是目标啊，还是怎样。但是我觉得顺服是很重要。那另外一个方面我也觉得摩西呢登山是不容易的，因为我们上过我们知道那个的挑战，但摩西是真的非常的顺服神在两个星期里面他上上下下七次，神要他领受话语，然后下去跟百姓说，再上去再对话各方面的，但是摩西真的没有怨言，他就是顺服的去做，
是，
所以对我另外一个层次来说，我就说到当神呼召我做一样东西的时候，有挑战吗？有的，有困难吗？有的，但是我要学习摩西的顺服程度，跟那个耐力，跟那个愿意真的为神摆上的那个的心智，所以我觉得摩西真的是让我学习一个很好的榜样，
是，所以一个领袖需要有的节制，
是，
因为就是你知道那个时间，我们就是要做这个决定的，所以我感谢神哦，他是 ECQ 可以做到这个决定，这就是领袖，这就是领袖，所以他们可以知道在什么点听，而且为大局想嘛，所以摩西也是领袖，因为他为全体百姓想，所以他去到神那里是危险的，因为没有人可以看见神，但是因为他的顺服和神对他的拣选，所以神向他显现，然后也只有他能够进去的，所以我觉得难怪神说嘛，摩西是不一样的，他真的是我的朋友，
是，
然后神跟他面对面啊，所以摩西是被神拣选，我们每个人都要效仿摩西，我们要像他这样，谦和，
是，
然后有 discipline， 有节制，然后懂得怎么样有分寸。所以我觉得这个是神用摩西的地方，还有 flexible 这一次我们在行程里面哈。我们都知道
对
last minute 改一个行程，就是把它整个调过来，
是，
结果一调呢原来就是上 Split Rock 的时候，因为你还要再爬的哦，那天是比较阴天的，
是
比较舒服的，然后另外一天是没有这样多在户外的，那一天是特别炎热的，
是，
所以你看这是我们不知道的东西，但是顺着圣灵的带领和感动，结果我们就在 Speed Rock 完成我们的里程，
对，
哇，那一个里程跟我们第一次去又完全不一样，非常有恩膏，
是，
我们感觉我们是带着得胜回来，
因为哎呀，我们在那边主坛最后的坛呢是在那个耶和华尼西的坛，我们做那个宣告，但是我们也演一套戏，我们的戏呢就是亚玛力人在征战的时候，我们这个
耶稣亚
我们的这个摩西在山上，乌尔亚伦在山上托着摩西的手举起来，耶稣亚在山下打胜亚玛力人，
是
这个战很壮观，
是很壮观因为带我们的是我们新加坡以前的军官所以非常有气势啊，只有五个人好像千军万马，
对对对，
所以那个感觉非常好、嗯、我自己都很投入在、整个过程，所以我感觉 it's a good ending、
Amen.
it's a、得胜的 ending
胜，
所以我很感谢神，原来每一次到回同样的点都有不同的领受，有新的景点、
Amen.
新的体会、
嗯
但愿我们这一次把西乃山的恩膏就在我们但以理的进食里边，真的把这一份带给弟兄姐妹，
在音乐节，
所以我们是代表你们再上去跟神面对面，然后再一次的、带回这一个非常非常不同的一个荣耀和得胜、嗯、所以我在这里说弟兄姐妹、嗯、你是得胜、
Amen.
在基督里你永远是得胜军、
Amen.
奉耶稣的名祝福你们哦。好，我们跟大家说再见哦，
拜拜，神祝福。
弟兄姐妹们平安。
Peace to you, brothers and sisters.
你跟你旁边讲说你是得胜的。
Say to the one next to you, you are victorious.
啊、谢谢牧师 Pastor Amos 带我们去这一次的西乃山。
I'm very grateful that Reverend Aston and Amos brought us to Mount Sinai this round.
谢谢 Pastor Ezekiel 非常的顺服。
And thanks to Pastor Ezekiel for being so obedient.
如果那一刻我们硬硬闯上山顶的话
，If we continue on at that moment，
接下来我们就在天上见。
We may meet each other at heaven.
然后都是黑人一块。
And we are all will be so darkened and
被烧焦了。
Because we are all burned.
好，我们教会很看重我们的下一代。
Our church places importance on the next generation.
很看重两代的合一。
The unity between two generations.
上个星期 Pastor Charlotte 分享信息的时候。
Last week when Pastor Charlotte shared about the message.
当他讲到他跟 Pastor Ezekiel 很爱神。
She shared about how Pastor Ezekiel and her love the Lord.
可是他们的孩子以后会不会这样的跟随神呢？
But she is questioning whether their children will follow God likewise.
他讲到这里，其实也是我的顾虑啊。
I have the same concern when she spoke about this.
以后我们孩子还不会会不会像我们这样子爱神跟随神呢？
Whether our children will follow God like us.
其实也是好像是一个问号。
It is a question mark.
我们可以做的就是教导他们，然后为他们来祷告。
What we can do is to teach them and pray for them.
原来现在呢，我们不只是在面对这一个打仗，我们不只是面对这一个全球性的，我们在面对这个全球性的危机。
In fact, now we are facing the global crisis.
第一个就是打仗。
There's war.
打仗过后，我们就看到经济的危机嘛。
Following that, we see financial crisis.
然后接下来我们就看到整个的天灾人祸。
And we see crisis of natural disasters.
地震。
Earthquake.
水灾。
Flood.
就是然后就是 global warming.
And global warming.
这些事情发生的时候就会影响农作物。
All of this, when it happens, it affects the crops.
就会面对到粮食的危机。
And we will have the lack of food supply.
这个是很真实的东西。
This is a real issue.
我们都可以在新闻上看到这些的报道。
We read about all of this in the news.
可是还有一个危机呢。
There is another crisis.
全球性的危机是没有在新闻上报道的。
Which is also a global crisis but not reported in the news.
可是跟我和你呢是息息相关的。
Yet it is closely related to you and I.
这个是什么危机呢？
And what crisis is that?
就是信仰的危机。
That is the crisis of faith.
就是我们对神的信仰。
That is our faith towards God.
这个是个全球性的危机来的。
This is a global crisis.
全世界最大的教会在韩国。
The biggest church is in Korea.
可是现在这个最大教会的会友呢，平均岁数是50多岁。
Yet this biggest church in the world, the average age of the congregation is above 50 years old.
他们的年轻人，他们的下一代去了哪里？
Where has the young people and next generation gone?
他们不再去教会了。
They no longer attend church.
他们的信仰的根基也模糊了。
They have blurred the foundation of their faith.
所以为什么我开始明白 Pastor Anden 每次来的时候跟我们讲说你要为下一代祷告，要为下一代祷告。
Therefore, I started to understand why Pastor Anden always asks us to pray for our next generation.
原来我们就在面对这个全球性信仰的危机。
Because now we are facing this global crisis of faith.
那我们可以怎样做？
And what can we do?
我们的两代要起来。
Our both generations shall rise up.
要为信仰来征战。
To fight for our faith.
今天我会跟 Pastor Sarah 来分享这个主题。
I will share this message with Pastor Sarah today.
两代要为信仰而战。
Two generations fight for faith.
然后我们会回到我们这次去沙特阿拉伯的一个地方，叫做利菲丁。
We have been to this place, Rephidim, in Saudi Arabia this round.
也是在磐石出水的事件上，我们来更深的去看神的话。
This is also the incident of the split rock of the water.
出埃及记十七章一到第三节。
Exodus chapter 17, verse 1 to 3.
以色列全会众都遵耶和华的吩咐，按着战口从逊的旷野往前行，在利非丁安营。百姓没有水喝，所以与摩西争闹说，给我们水喝吧。摩西对他们说，你们为什么与我争闹，为什么试探耶和华呢？百姓在那里甚渴，要喝水，就向摩西发怨言说，你们为什么将我们从埃及领出来，使我们和我们的儿女并牲畜都渴死呢？
这个时候呢，这两百多万人刚刚从埃及出来。
These 2 million people has just came out from Egypt.
他们过了红海。
They have passed through the Red Sea.
要往西乃山去。
They're heading towards Mount Sinai.
然后中途呢，就来到这个地方叫做利非丁。
And they came across this place called Rephidim.
那个时候他们面对到一个问题。
And they face this issue.
就是他们没有水喝。
That is, they do not have water.
牛羊没有水喝。
They have no water.
非常的口渴。
They were so thirsty.
然后他们带着一家大小。
With their family, big and young.
如果孩子没有水喝呢，就开始闹啊。
The children, when they do not have water, they will make a lot of noise.
然后父母的情绪就很急躁了。
And the emotion of the parents will be aroused.
所以他们就开始对摩西发怨言。
So they started to complain to Moses.
跟摩西争闹。
And they contended with Moses.
到一个地步呢，甚至要拿石头打死摩西了。
To the extent that they want to stone Moses to death.
他们关系就开始在那边出现了个破裂。
And hence, there's this breakdown in relationship.
所以摩西也不知道可以做什么。
And Moses didn't know what to do then.
他就去祷告神。
He went to pray to God.
然后第四节。
And verse 4.
摩西就呼求耶和华说，我向这百姓怎样行呢？他们几乎要拿石头打死我。耶和华对摩西说，你手里拿着你先前击打河水的杖，带领以色列的几个长老从百姓面前走过去。我必在河裂的磐石那里站在你面前，你要击打磐石，从磐石里必有水流出来，使百姓可以喝。摩西就在以色列的长老眼前这样行了。
摩西跟神说，神啊，我可以做什么？
Moses asked God, God, what can I do?
我去那里拿水给他们喝啊。
Where can I find water for the people?
他们要拿石头打死我啊。
They want to stone me to death.
然后神就跟摩西讲说，
And hence God told Moses,
现在拿着你手中之前击打河水的杖，
Bring the rod that you strike the stone.
然后你要带几个长老，
And bring along some elders too.
在百姓的面前走过去，
Pass through the people.
然后去在磐石的上面，
Go to the stone.
这几个长老就是摩西的保镖。
And they are the personal bodyguard for Moses.
啊，百姓看到长老在。
They saw the elders.
啊，就不会把石头打他们。
Hence, they will not stone Moses.
所以当摩西爬到那个就是磐石的时候。
When Moses reached the rock.
神跟他讲非常重要的一句话。
And God spoke this very important thing to him.
就在第六节。
That's at verse 6.
很关键的一节。
That's an important phrase.
它原文的意思是这样说的。
The original text said so.
神跟摩西讲说，看啊，
Behold,
我要在那里站在你面前。
Behold, I shall be there, standing before you.
站在河裂的磐石上面。
Standing on the rock.
然后你就击打磐石。
When you hit the rock,
磐石就会有水流出来。
There'll be water flowing from here.
然后就可以给百姓喝。
So that the people can drink.
神就跟摩西讲说，
And God told Moses,
我必跟你同去。
I shall be there with you.
当你看见我的荣耀降下来，站在磐石上面的时候，
When you see my glory ascended,
你就要拿你手中的杖，
stretch out your rod,
击打那个磐石，
and hit the rock.
磐石就会裂开，
and the rock shall split.
水就会流出来，
and water shall flow from there.
当摩西这样子做的时候，
When Moses did wise,
果然磐石裂开。
And the rock was split.
流出来的水
and water flowed from
可以供应200多万的以色列人。
The water was sufficient to feed the 2 million people.
还有数千只的牛羊。
As well as the livestock.
弟兄姐妹，这个是大神迹来的。
This is a great miracle.
刚才你看到画面，很干的地方，竟然有那么的水涌流出来。
The place that you saw that was so dry just now, there was water flowing from there.
如果我们当时候
If we then,
是那一群发怨言要拿石头打摩西的人,
were the people that complained and wanted to stone Moses to death.
你看到这一个的神迹,
and if you see this miracle,
你会吓吧?
Will you be shocked?
你会害怕吗?
Will you be fearful?
如果是我的话,
if I am the one,
我会害怕,
I will be fearful.
我也会敬畏啊,
and I will revere.
我怕神把那个石头滚下来压死我啊,
because I'm scared that God will punish me with this rock.
我们来看一些的照片。
Let us look at some pictures. Okay.
这个就是我们的 GA team.
This is the team from us, GA.
你看到那个磐石就在后面。
And you see the rock behind?
然后第二张。
And the next picture?
这个就是我们爬上去那个磐石的时候。
And this is when we ascend the rock.
你看到后面那个黑影吗?
And you see the dark shadow?
那个人就是我。
That's me.
所以你可以想象这个磐石其实是很大颗的。
So the rock is truly huge.
我们看那个video。
Let us look at one video.
当我们爬上去的时候,
when we ascended the mountain,
你看我们的体积好像一只蚂蚁这样子而已。
You see, we are like ants.
所以这个磐石是很大的。
So the rock is really huge.
我们用了大概13分钟从下面爬到上去。
We used 13 minutes to ascend from the bottom to the top.
当上去那边我们就要祷告，就要做先知性的行动。
When we were at the top, we prayed and we did prophetic act.
就是要击打磐石。
That is to hit the rock.
然后我是扮演摩西那个角色。
And I act the character of Moses.
你知道在当下其实我很害怕的。
You know, I was so fearful then.
因为那个磐石已经裂开了啊。
Because the rock actually has already split.
如果我再打多一次的话,
if I continue to hit on it,
天上有一个声音来。
If there is a voice from heaven,
Elijah, 为什么你击打磐石?
Elijah, why did you hit the rock?
你不能进入应许之地。
You cannot enter into the promised land.
哇，那个时候我就要滚下山了，你知道吗？
And at that time, I will be in great trouble.
可是确实我真的是害怕的那一刻。
Truly, I was in fear at that time.
所以我先悔改先。
So I repented at that time. And I prayed to God.
然后就击打磐石。
And I hit the rock.
然后巴士基哥把水倒下来，宣告那个水涌流出来。
And Pastor Ezekiel poured water down from there and proclaimed that water shall flow from there.
其实那一刻呢，我很敬畏神啊。
I truly revere God at
that moment. A
sudden revere come upon me.
因为那个磐石,
because of the rock.
就是耶稣基督来的,
that was Jesus Christ.
预表耶稣基督来的,
that represents Jesus Christ.
我们看哥林多前书10章1到4节。
Let us look at the book of Corinthians chapter 10 verse 1 to 4.
弟兄们,我不愿意你们不晓得,我们的祖宗从前都在云下,都从海中经过,都在云里海里休息。 归了摩西，并且都吃了一样的灵食，也都喝了一样的灵水，说喝的是出于随着他们的灵磐石，那磐石就是基督。那磐石就是基督。That
rock was Christ.
你看旁边讲说，那磐石就是耶稣。Say
to the one next to you that the rock is Christ.
当神的荣耀降在那个磐石上面的时候，
when God's glory ascend to the rock,
那个磐石呢就成为圣。
The rock is sanctified.
就预表着耶稣基督。
That represents Jesus Christ.
当神叫摩西击打磐石。
At that time when God commanded Moses to
strike
the rock. 磐石裂开。 The rock split.
出水。
And water flow from it.
预表有一天耶稣基督。
It represents that one day Jesus Christ.
会为了拯救我们他牺牲他自己。
For salvation's sake, he will sacrifice himself.
他身体会裂开。
That his body will be broken.
然后所有相信耶稣的人。
And whoever believes in Jesus
就可以得着这个救恩的泉源,
shall receive this salvation.
可是当时候我们来想一下,
let us ponder on this point.
当耶稣受害的时候呢,
when Jesus was suffering,
人家以为他犯罪, 所以神击打他。
Many thought that he had sinned, therefore God struck him and punished him.
可是圣经讲说, 耶稣基督是因为为了我们的过犯和罪孽呢, 他受鞭伤。
But the Bible recorded that he was wounded for our transgressions.
好让我们得医治,
so that we will be healed.
他受刑罚, 我们得平安。
The chastisements for our peace was upon
耶稣基督把救恩带给了我们。
He brought along salvation for us.
然后当时候,
at that time,
这些200多万在喝这磐石流出来的水。
The 2 million people who drank the water that flowed from the rock.
其实他们知道这个磐石就是他们的，预表他们的弥赛亚吗？
Did they understand that this rock actually represent their Messiah?
其实他们不知道的。
They did not.
他们可能觉得这个 take for granted, 觉得这个是应该的。
Perhaps they take things for granted and they think that they are entitled to it.
然后他们的下一代更不知道。
And more so to their next generation.
因为有水流出来，快就快点喝嘛。
Because when water flow from there, they quickly drink.
可以解渴就很好了。
It is good that they no longer thirsty.
再回想，就好像今天我们很多的就是我们的孩子们。
Let us reflect.On our children nowadays,
他们一出世就在基督教的家庭。
When they are born, they grow up in a Christian family.
从小就跟父母来教会。
Since young, they come to church with their family.
然后就觉得好像一个理所当然的东西。
They think this is something that they are entitled for.
其实对救恩的根基，其实可能还不清楚的。
Perhaps they are very blur in their foundation of their faith.
当我们读圣经的历史
，When we read about the history in the
Bible, 我们知道过后。耶稣亚带领这200万的以色列人进入应许之地的时候
，We know that when Joshua brought along the 2 million people enter into the promised land，
当耶稣亚死了之后
，After Joshua passed away，
圣经讲说这新一代的以色列人不认识耶和华
，The Bible recorded that this new generation do not know Yahweh God，
他们放弃他们信仰的根基
，And they forsake the foundation of their faith。
拜偶像
and they worship idols,
行神眼中看为恶的事
and they did what is considered evil in the eyes of the Lord.
这个恶性的循环延续了千多年了
and this vicious cycle continued for over 1,000 years.
所以所有亲爱的弟兄姐妹们
therefore brothers and sisters,
我们今天在新约的教会我们必须要知道
we live in the church in the New Testament, we must understand this.
我们下一代更需要知道
Our next generation likewise need to know.
因为他们在面对这人类历史中很大的一场征战。
Because they are facing the great warfare in the humankind.
我让大家看两个的 facts.
Let me show you these two facts.
看到你会很震惊的。
You will be shocked.
第一个。
The first.
按照世界卫生组织的 WHO 的数据。
According to the World Health Organization record and statistics,
全世界每年约有7300万人堕胎。
There were about 33 million induced abortion annually.
这个是没有包括那些没有呈上去的数据。
This is excluding the unreported cases.
7300万等于马来西亚两倍的人口。
37 million is equivalent to 2 times of the population of Malaysia.
平均每天有200,000的人被堕的孩子的婴孩被堕胎。
That means averagely there were about 200,000 child being aborted daily.
所以我们这里的每一个人可以坐在这里。
Therefore, every one of us here sitting here.
我们有救恩。
We have salvation.
这个不是理所当然的。
This is not something.
这个是神的恩典。
To take for granted, but this is the grace of God.
所以我们可以坐在这里是很宝贝的。
So it is truly precious that we are seated here.
你知道这个是一个大屠杀来的吗
？Do you know this is a great killing?
一天200,000了。
200,000 per day.
的人命。
That is life.
第二个。
And secondly,
我们马来西亚人每一天上网的时间是9小时4分钟。
The Malaysians spend about 9 hours 4 minutes daily in the internet.
在当中的 Z generation,
and the Z generation,
就是大概是12岁到27岁。现在
that is at the age of 12 to 27 years old.
平均每天在社交媒体上花费的时间呢，大概是4.5小时。
They averagely spend 4.5 hours per day on social media.
这个预表着什么
？What does this represent?
这个世界在门训我们的孩子。
That the world is actually educating our children.
很多世界的价值观就透过这社交媒体来灌输他们。
A lot of value, the worldly value system is educated to them through this.
我们已经在一个 AI 的 generation.
Yes, we live in an AI generation.
所以有听过 Metaverse 的，请你举手一下。
Who has heard about Metaverse? Can you raise your hand?
不多。
Not many.
这个是个叫做多元宇宙。
This is a universe.
它的目的就是要把世界所有在实体的东西呢放在一个虚拟世界里面。
To put everything in the world into the virtual world.
只要你戴上一个 VR.
So long as you put on the VR.
你可以做所有你在平时可以做的事情。
You can do all things that you do in the world.
这个是接下来10年、20年的 trend.
That will be the trend in the upcoming 10 to 20 years.
你可以想象到以后我们的下一代可能他们都不会出现在实体的崇拜。
So can you imagine our next generation will no longer come to the church for physical
service? 人跟人之间有一个很大的隔阂。
There will be a great gap between humans.
当他们开始脱下他们 VR 的时候
，When they no longer put on your VR,
他们会陷入一个状况。
They will fall into this situation.
叫做 depression.
That is depression.
因为在虚拟的世界和现实世界相差太远了。
Because there's great difference in the real world and the virtual world.
所以你看到撒旦杀不死我们的下一代。
You see how Satan he couldn't kill our next generation.
他就把他们孤立起来。
And he will try to seclude them.
然后去误导他们。
And mislead them.
弟兄姐妹，这个是个全球性信仰的征战来的。
Brothers and sisters, this is a global crisis of faith.
圣经预言在末后的日子会有很多离教反道的事。
And the Bible has prophesied that there will be a lot of acts of apostasy.
什么叫离教反道呢
？And what does that mean?
就是本来是信耶稣的。
That means those who originally believed in
Christ. 后来放弃信仰。
They let go of their belief.
还起来抵挡基督。
And they become antichrist.
所以我们要怎么做
？So what shall we do?
我们需要改变。
We need to change.
我们真的是需要改变。
We truly need to change.
改变要付代价。
And we need to pay a price for the change.
不改变要付更大的代价。
If you do not change, that there is greater price for you to pay.
我们两代需要走在一起。
Two generations shall walk together.
我们需要更深的认识耶稣。
We need to understand Jesus deeper.
并且要一直的经历他。
And continuously encounter him.
要在神的话语建立一个非常稳固的信仰的根基。
To build solid foundation in the words of God.
可以扎实在这个救恩的磐石上面。
So that it can be built on this rock of salvation.
耶稣说过。
And that is what Jesus has promised. 我要把
我的教会建立在这个磐石上。
That he shall build his church on this rock.
我们上下一代两代要合一。
The earlier and the next generation shall be united.
我们需要一起来面对现在所发生的事。
We shall face the crisis that we are facing together.
去面对这一场的征战。
And face this warfare together.
Amen.
Amen.
我把时间交给 Pastor Sarah.
I'll hand over the time to Pastor Sarah.
谢谢 Pastor Sigil.
Thank you,
Elijah.
Sorry.
大家好。
Hello, everyone.
很感恩，真的是我们要两代一起与神来去得胜。
I'm so grateful that two generations shall walk together to gain victory.
现在的危机真的是越来越靠近。
The crisis is nearing.
神也透过先知来提醒了我们。
And through prophets, God had reminded us.
那么圣经里面有没有什么属灵征战得胜的原则呢？
Is there any biblical spiritual principle for spiritual warfare? Yes, there is.
我们就继续来看八到十六节。
Let us continue on verses 8 until 16. 我们先
读第八节。
We'll read verse 8 first.
那时，亚玛利人来在利非丁和以色列人征战。
好，那个时候是什么时候呢？
What time was it referring?
就是神让以色列人有水喝之后。
That is after God provided water for the people.
神已经满足以色列人肉体的需要。
God has satisfied the physical need of the people.
以色列人也好像过了一关的试炼。
As if the Israelites had passed one hurdle.
再来到另外一关。
And now they came to the second one.
就是一个属灵的一个试炼。
That is a spiritual warfare or test.
就是以色列人要面对亚玛力人来跟他们征战了。
The Israelites need to face the war with the Amalekites.
那么亚玛利人是谁呢？
And who are these Amalekites?
他们是以扫的孙子的后裔。
They are the descendants of Esau's grandchildren.
以扫是谁？
And who is Esau?
就是雅各，就是又名以色列的双胞胎哥哥。
That is the brother of the twin brother of Israel or Jacob.
所以他们是亲戚关系啊，以色列人跟亚玛利人。
Therefore, the Amalekites and the Israel actually they were cousins.
而且亚玛利人当时候呢，应该不是住在利非丁的。
And the Amalekites did not dwell in Rephidim then.
他们是游牧民族。
They were travelers.
他们住在迦南南部。
They were living in the southwestern part of Canaan.
但是这个时候呢，他们来到利非丁要跟以色列人征战。
They came to Rephidim to war with the Israelites.
以色列人没有触犯到他们呐。
The Israelites actually didn't offend them.
没有要争夺他们的土地啊。
They didn't want to fight for their land.
可是以色列人就这样子来去 亚玛力人就这样子来去跟他征战了。
But the Amalekites came to war with them.
所以申命记25章17节说到，
Therefore, in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 25, verse 17, it says,
他说到当亚玛力人呢， 以色列人出埃及的时候，亚玛力人在路上呢，趁着以色列人疲乏困倦的时候，在后面呢攻击以色列人，并不敬畏神。
Remember what Amalek did to you on the ways as you were coming out of Egypt. How he met you on the way and attacked your rear ranks.
原来当他们这样子攻击以色列人的时候，神称他们是不敬畏神的。
When they attacked the Israelites in such a manner, God deemed that they did not fear God.
从什么事情上显出他们不敬畏神呢？
What did it mean when they did not fear God?
因为他们抵挡神的旨意成就。
Because they resist the will of God.
神要引领以色列人进他的目的地就是进去应许之地。
God intended to bring the Israelites into the promised land.
但是这一些的亚玛力人呢，就是从另外一边就是要来拦阻以色列人要进去应许之地。
Yet these Amalekites came from another direction trying to resist and hinder the Israelites from entering into the promised land.
这个行为是不敬畏神的。
This is something that do not revere God.
再加上他们称人之为。
In addition to that, they are taking advantage of others' danger.
当以色列人出埃及的时候，来到旷野需要帮助的时候，
When the Israelite has exceeded Egypt and they need help then,
身为兄弟，不单只没有给出援手，
As the brother, not only that they did not help,
反而要攻打他们，
But they attacked them.
所以神非常不喜悦。
And this displeases God.
所以这场征战呢，可以说不是人跟人的征战。
Therefore, this warfare is not deemed a warfare between humankind.
是神跟魔鬼仇敌的征战。
But it's a warfare between God and the devil.
那么如果属灵征战的话，就要用属灵的原则跟策略了。
Since it's a spiritual warfare, the spiritual principle shall apply.
我们继续看9到11节。
Let us continue to look at verses 9 and 10.
摩西对约书亚说：“你为我们选出人来，出去和亚玛力人征战。明天我手里要拿着神的杖，站在山顶上。”于是约书亚照着摩西对他所说的话行，和亚玛力人征战。摩西、亚伦与户珥都上了山顶。摩西何时举手，以色列人就得胜；何时垂手，亚玛力人就得胜。好，摩西在这时候呢，他就有一个的策略。
There is this strategy by Moses at that time.
就是他叫约书亚为他选出人来去跟亚玛力人征战。And
he asked Joshua to choose the people to fight with the Amalek.
那约书亚呢，在圣经里面这里是第一次出现他的名字。The
name of Joshua first appeared in this chapter.
而且以色列人第一次征战。And
it is the first warfare for the Israelites.
因为我们知道以色列人从哪里来啊。
Because we know where did the Israelites come from.
他们之前在埃及是为奴的。They
were slaves in Egypt then.
根本不会征战。They
did not know any warring skill.
而且约书亚当时候才二十几岁。And
Joshua was only 20s.
是可以出战的年龄。It
is an age suitable to enter into warfare.
可是他是在埃及长大，他不会征战的。Yet
he grew up in Egypt and he doesn't understand about warring.
要他选出人来去征战。
And yet he need to select the people.
可是约书亚非常顺服。Yet
Joshua was so obedient.
就照样做。And
he followed accordingly.
那老一辈的摩西呢？
Moses, who is of the earlier generation.
他就带着亚伦和户珥呢上山。He
brought along Aaron and Hur and ascended the hill.
就是刚才主任牧师的话，Pastor Amos提到的。That
is the one that Pastor Amos has mentioned in the word of senior pastor.
但是刚才镜头没有转到 Pastor Amos身上。
But the camera did not show at Reverend Amos.
我们在那里呢，撒地阿拉伯也做了一个先知性行动。
We have did this prophetic act in Saudi Arabia.
就是在利非丁那个地方。
That is at Rephidim.
我们选一个地方，就是 Pastor Amos 代表摩西。
At that place, Pastor Amos represent Moses.
上到一座山。
Ascended a hill.
站着举手。
standing there and raised his hand.
然后呢，我们 GK 的陈牧师，还有 GT 的彼得牧师
，Pastor from GK and GT，
他们就啊拖着 Pastor Amos 的手
，They hold on to Pastor Amos' hands.
然后我们镜头刚才是看到约书亚在下面呼呼征战的。
The camera was showing how Joshua battled on the ground.
所以呢，这一个属灵征战。的那个的场面哦，的原则是什么呢
？So the scene and principle of this spiritual warfare，
原来就是山上可以决定山下。
Actually, is what happens in the mountain top can determine what's happening at the bottom of the hill。
当摩西举手
，When Moses held his hands high，
约书亚就可以打胜。
Joshua has the victory。
手撑下来
，When he put his hand down，
约书亚就打败。
Joshua was defeated.
手代表什么呢
？What does the hands represent?
圣经这里讲到手呢，代表权柄啊。
The Bible refers the hands to authority here.
而且摩西的手上是有神的杖。
And in Moses' hand there was this rod from God.
神呢已经给过摩西权柄。
God has given the authority to Moses.
所以当权柄者他举起手的时候
，When the authority held their hands up。
下一代的约书亚就可以连连得胜。
Joshua of the next generation has continuous victories.
所以这个属灵原则、哦、看起来是很简单。
This spiritual principle seems very easy.
也不需要怎么打过仗。
That you do not require any knowledge of warring.
但是原则对就可以打胜了。
And by following this, you will have the victory.
所以我们是属于哪一代啊？
So which generation are we?
我们是属于上一代还是下一代呢
？Are we of the earlier generations or the next generation?
当然，当你有那个时候的权柄的时候，你就是上一代了。
Of course, when you have the authority, you are the earlier generation.
在家庭里面，每一个父母哦，其实都是孩子的权柄。
In the family, all parents are the authority for their children.
父母要举手，拿起权柄。
Parents shall hold the hand up and exercise the authority
遮盖你的孩子
to cover the children.
孩子要听命顺服权柄
Children shall obey to the authority.
那下一代呢？他们的工作、他们的学业、他们的征战呢，都得胜
Then the next generation, their work, their studies, and whatever challenges that they face will have the victory.
这个就是一个属灵原则。
This is a spiritual principle.
那牧师呢是我的摩西。
So Reverend Esther is my Moses.
当他叫我去牧养的时候
，When she asked me to shepherd,
我就去学习去牧养。
I learned how to shepherd.
然后我认定牧师是我的权柄。
And I acknowledge Reverend Esther as my authority.
我也愿意活在她的遮盖下。
And I'm willing to live under her covering.
在牧养这件事情上，很多时候不明白的时候就去问她。
A lot of times when I face something that I do not understand in shepherding, I will ask of her.
有一些的组员需要属灵征战的一些的状况里面的时候，更加要跟牧师来分享。
When some of my cell members need to go into spiritual warfare, for sure I'll discuss with Reverend Esther.
当她举起她的权柄来遮盖我的时候
，When she exercises her authority to cover me,
哎，我的牧养就可以顺畅了
，And my shepherding will go on smoothly.
我真的是很感恩有属灵父母
，I'm truly grateful to have spiritual parents.
因为他们非常信任我
，Because they truly trust in me.
在很多的事上呢。我觉得我很有底气，是因为他们遮盖我。
I find that I have great confidence in many matters is because of their covering.
所以原来两代一起去这样子联手去征战的时候，是非常美、非常有保护和遮盖的。
Therefore, it's truly beautiful and with protection when two generations gain victory together.
所以不要问为什么啊，应不应该顺服权柄啊。
Therefore, do not ask why or should I obey or submit to my authority.
只要认定。专一跟随，我们就必定得胜。
So long as after you have acknowledged and follow, focus wholeheartedly, you will have the victory.
但是摩西呢，有时候手会发沉哦。
You know, sometimes Moses will feel tired and his hand will come down.
十二十三节就讲到，他们呢，亚伦胡尔就搬石头来放在他以下。
Verses 12 and 13 talk about Aaron and Hur. They bring along the rock and stand beside him.
然后摩西就坐在上面，亚伦户尔就扶着他的手。
Hence Moses sat on them, and Aaron and her supported his hands.
他的手就稳住一直到日落。
And his hands were steady until the going down of the sun.
然后约书亚就可以用刀杀了亚玛力王和他的百姓。
So Joshua defeated Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword.
因为我们的领袖有时候也会累。
You know, our authorities will get tired sometimes.
这需要就要时候就需要亚伦和户珥。
At this time, they will need Aaron and her.
那谁是亚伦户珥呢
？So who is Aaron and her?
就是权柄身边的人。
Those are the right-hand men beside the authority.
有时我们是牧师的约书亚。
Sometimes we are Joshua for our reverend.
有时我们核心同工还有牧师第一层门徒呢，就是牧师夫妇的亚伦和户珥。
Sometimes the steering committee or the first tier MG12 would be Aaron and her for Reverend Esther and Amos.
特别当他们要出去做属灵征战或者是开分堂的时候
，especially when they are going out for spiritual warfare or planting churches，
真的需要亚伦户珥来一起联手。
They truly need the help of Aaron and her，
托住他们的手
，to support their hands。
那么我们的分堂，我们一些的属灵走祷的事情就可以成就。
Therefore, our daughter churches and some of the spiritual warfare, we will have this victory.
所以我们不管我们做多少，或者是我们会不会
，irrespective of how much we have done or whether we know it or not,
在面对属灵的征战里面，真的是在站对属灵的原则的位置啊，就可以得胜。
When we are facing spiritual warfare, it is important that we stand on the right spiritual principle.
接下来我们看14到16节。
Next, we'll look at verses 14 and 16.
耶和华对摩西说，我要将亚玛利人、亚玛利的名号从全天下全然涂抹了。你要将这话写在书上做纪念，又念给约书亚听。摩西筑了一座坛，起名叫耶和华尼西，又说耶和华已经起了誓，必世世代代和亚玛利人征战。
这时候呢，耶和华吩咐摩西说
：“And at this moment, Lord commanded Moses
要把书上的话呢，要念给约书亚听啊。
To read what is stated on the book to Joshua，
就是要将亚玛利人的名号从天下涂抹。”
That is to blot out the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven.
刚才讲到亚玛利人就是抵挡神的作为的所有的仇敌。
We mentioned about Amalekites were the one that resist God's plan.
今天来说也可以说是我们就是属灵征战里面的就是魔鬼撒旦。
It also refers to the devil Satan.
魔鬼撒旦就是要来破坏我们的下一代和我们所有的人。
The devil Satan came here to harm our next generation and all the people.
但是呢，在这时候呢，神叫摩西说：“你要把书上的话念给约书亚听，要让下一代知道谁是我们的敌人。”
And now, God commanded Moses to read to Joshua so that Joshua understand.
因为我们现在的下一代，他们知道他们要面对什么挑战吗
？So that the next generation understand what challenges will they face.
我觉得有时候我们太保护我们的下一代，什么东西都保护他们，他们根本没有作战的能力啊。
Sometimes we are overly protective towards our next generation that they are unable to face the war.
他们不知道他们的亚玛力人是谁。
They don't even know who are dear Amalekites.
是魔鬼撒旦的作为。
Those are the works of the devil Satan.
诶，魔鬼撒旦是怎么样的
？And how does devil Satan look like?
在哪里
？Where are they?
他们可能觉得是天荒夜谭。
Perhaps they do not understand and do not believe.
但是我们知道，今天刚才 Pastor Elijah 也是有分享，很多的网络的事情的世界都被这个敌基督来去掌控着。
As what has been shared by Pastor Elijah just now, a lot of the antichrist elements has been shared in the internet.
没有办法，他们一出世就是在有网络的时代。
We can't help because they live in this digital era.
他们无法想象没有网络是怎么过的。
They couldn't imagine how they can live their life without internet.
他们要的资料什么随手可得。
They can easily get all the information that they want just A click away.
他们要的娱乐也是在网上随手可得。
The entertainment that they desired of can also easily be retrieved from the internet.
刚才讲到虚拟世界 VR.
We talk about the virtual world, VR, just now.
可能很多不明白的人，他们也沉迷在里面了。
A lot of people actually do not understand about this, yet they are addicted to it.
不要讲年轻的一代，我们这个时代的人哦，也是非常沉迷网络的。
Not just the younger generation, even us, the elder generation, we are also addicted to the internet.
刚才 Pastor 也在讲哦，马来西亚人平均一个人上网一天九个多小时。
Just now, Pastor Elijah shared about one Malaysian spend one day 9 hours plus in the internet.
我们的年轻人 Gen Z 一天上网四个多小时。
The Gen Z spend 4.5 hours.
其他的时间是谁上啊？
So the who spend the hours for the balance hours?
其实不管什么年代，都很容易被这个的诱惑而 trap 进去了。
So irrespective of the age, we can easily fall into this trap.
所以今天我们真的是要两代一起联手。
Therefore, today we shall work hand in hand two generations.
做约书亚的真的是要信任我们的上一代啊。
So for Joshua, we need to truly trust in our earlier generation.
信任我们的父母还有属灵权柄。
Trust in our parents as well as spiritual authority.
他们真的不是要害我们的。
They truly not want to harm us.
他们要来遮盖我们。
They want to cover us.
他们手上有权柄。
They have authority in their hands.
他们很乐意举手，为我们举手。
Willingly, they will hold their hand for us.
做约书亚的，只要在属灵里面站稳、征战，就必得胜。
For the Joshua, you just need to stand still and you shall have the spiritual victory.
所以得胜需要两代。
Hence, the victory requires two generations.
不单只两代，三代，世世代代都要连在一起。
Actually, it's more than two generations. It's three generations or many generations to stand together.
好，我们同站立来敬拜我们的神。
Let us rise and worship God.
是的，主，是你让我们征战得胜。
Yes, God, you are our victory.
主，让我们举起我们的手，不疲乏的，一直不断的祷告。
Let us raise our hand and pray unceasingly.
你来带领我们。
You lead us.
哈利路亚。
哈利路亚。
举起手，我们旗开得胜，耶和华是力量。不疲乏，我们手不下沉，耶和华是君王。
Because the Israelites have the victory.
摩西就筑了一座坛，称为耶和华尼西。
Hence Moses built an altar and called it Jehovah Nisi.
今天这个得胜的坛也在我们当中。
Today this altar of victory is also in our midst.
因为有耶稣基督成为我们信仰的根基。
Because Jesus Christ has become the solid foundation of our faith.
他就是我们的磐石。
He is our rock.
信仰这个的要沦落的这个的危机
，the crisis of faith，
我们真的是不可以轻看。
We must place importance to it。
不单指我们的信仰
，not only our faith。
当我去到沙特阿拉伯的时候
，when I reached Saudi Arabia，
他们的信仰
，their faith，
快要沦陷了。
It's also in crisis。
年轻人都不爱上他们的地方去念经。
The young people do not like to go to the places for prayer.
今天属神的子民，他们爱来到神的教会来敬拜神吗？
people of God, do we like to come to church to worship Him?
真的，这个的负担在我们的身上啊。
This burden truly is
在我们的心里面。
In our hearts,
真的盼望我们两代都可以起来，世世代代都可以起来。
Two generations shall rise up, and all generations shall rise up.
现在我们要做一个先知性行动。
Let us do this prophetic act now.
在第一堂也做过了。
We have did this in the first service.
就是35岁以下的年轻人，请到台前。
That's those the young generation below 35 years old.
这个年龄是一个的代表。
This age group is a representation.
可能你超过这个年龄，但是你还是约书亚。
Perhaps you have already surpassed this age, yet you are still Joshua.
只是刚才因为第一堂都是呼召35岁以下的，所以我们这一堂也呼召35岁以下。
It is just that to be consistent with the first service, we call upon those who are 35 and below.
第一堂的人数不是很多
There weren't a lot in the first service
可能都来了昨天的那一堂
Perhaps they came yesterday
我不知道这一堂会不会比第二堂更多
I do not know whether the group here will be bigger than the one in the first service
其实站出来让我们看到我们的年轻人有没有在教会有多少 percent 的35岁以下在教会啊
Come to the front so that we can see how many of our young people come to the church for service.
如果很少的话，我们真的是要赶紧啊。
If the number is truly very small, we
have to. 他们去了哪里啊？
We have to be anxious.
我们的年轻人去了哪里啊？
And ask where is our young people.
当然还有在儿童教会。
Of course, some are in the children's church.
是这一些是我们的下一代。
These are our next generation.
然后在后面的，我们今天就是预表，我们就是上一代。
Those who are standing behind, it represents that you are the earlier generation.
前面的人，我们是约书亚。
Those who are standing in front, you are Joshua.
约书亚有勇敢的心智。
Joshua is courageous.
有顺服的灵。
Obedient.
当权柄说什么的时候，我们愿意听，愿意信任我们的。长辈
willing to obey and trust whatever our authorities speak to us
勇敢征战
to fight courageously
后面的呢就是我们真的是很愿意举起我们的权柄来遮盖他们
those who are standing behind truly we are willing to exercise our authority to cover and bless them
好吧我们请前面的人呢
let us invite
因为你们代表约书亚嘛
because you represent Joshua to war
你们就这样
you do this action
其实我们这样子来祷告的时候表示说我真的是约书亚我要起来征战我要知道我的敌人是谁
When we do that it represents that I am Joshua I want to enter into warfare and I want to know who is my enemy
就是魔鬼撒旦仇敌的作为
That is the devil Satan and his plot
我要勇敢的在我的地方来勇敢的为信仰而战
I want to courageously fight for my faith at the place where I am
然后请后面的我们就是举手
And those who are standing behind
代表我们是摩西我们愿意举手为我们的下一代来征战。
Raise your hand and bless the next generation. Pray for them and fight for them.
特别在信仰上
especially in their faith.
他们要更爱神。
They want to love God more.
他们要更敬畏神。
They need to revere God more.
他们要更知道神的心意是什么。
They need to know the heart of God.
他们要回应神的呼召。
They want to respond to God's calling.
进到神的命定。
And enter into God's calling.
我们每一代都要进到应许之地。
All generations shall enter into their respective promise.
没有任何一代是被忽略的。
No one generation is forgotten.
我们都是神的孩子。
We are all children of God.
有权柄的就举手。
Those with authority, exercise it.
有能力的就征战。
The one with power and might, go for the war.
让我们一起。
Let us do this together.
为着我们的信仰来征战。
Fight for our faith.
我们知道这个的摆正。对的时候
we know that when we stand right in this warfare,
神的恩膏和神的能力就可以透过我们流下来
God's anointing and power shall flow through us.
我们必定得胜
We shall have the victory.
是在我们的信仰上得胜
To have the victory in our faith.
感谢主
Thanks be to God.
奉耶稣的圣名祷告
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
我们期待的神耶和华是力量我疲乏我们从不下沉耶和华是君王耶和华苦磨我的敌人耶和华
神。主，我们的下一代要起来有能力征战。我宣告我们的下一代能够成为大能的勇士。主啊，求你恩待我们，教会所有年龄层从零岁一直到35岁的人。
All the ages of the church from 0 to 35 years old.
主啊，求你帮助他们
，Help them, Lord.
给他们力量
，Give them strength.
但愿他们征战得胜
，May they have victory in the warring.
他们能够辨别到谁是他们的敌人
，They will discern who is the enemy.
主，求你恩待他们
，Be gracious to them, Lord.
当我们举手的时候
，When we lift our
hands, 我们的这一代不会流逝的
，Our this generation will not be gone.
我们这一代一定在神的保护里面
，They will be in your protection.
我宣告他们在事业、在学校、在生活里面都能够为主做见证。
In their career, in their studies, and in their life, they can testify for you.
求主保护他们。
Keep them, Lord.
保守他们的心。
Protect their heart.
我宣告他们是你的大能勇士。
I declare that they will be your general.
主啊，凡乐意跟随你的。
Those who willingly follow you.
主，你让他们居首不居尾。
They will be on the top and not tail.
耶稣的名字
，In Jesus' name,
宣告他们要见证你的荣耀。
They will testify your glory.
谢谢你，我们这样的祷告奉耶稣的名。
Our prayer is in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
神祝福你们。愿我们摩西、约书亚都一同站立。
May Moses and Joshua rise up.
我们同心征战。
In unity we battle.
必能得胜。
And we shall have victory. Amen.
神祝福你们。我们今天的崇拜就到这里。
Our service will end here.